We're now at the harbors of Ventimiglia, which are on the beach with the fishermen. And so we can see that this harbor actually has cleansed, but not until the end. Yes, so as I said a month ago, they are blocked for their activity. I saw that the harbor beside has reopened a trench in the water, but you see still the amount of wood. And this one actually is opening the trench with this man who is digging in the wood, and it's a very hard job because do you see the size of the wood in front of us? It's just unbelievable. But that's the only way to reopen the beach for those fishermen, so they can go fishing and feed their family. And yes, so we see that the events of Storm Alex in Ventimiglia have many consequences, and they last, and yes, because we're nearly a month after the event, and see this man is still opening actually a trench in the wood, which is yeah, very blocking, you know, for his activities. And and sea has opened quite a road to reach the harbor, so the boats can go away. But it's a hard work, because if you consider the amount of wood, and still there is a step before reaching the water, so you have to dig a lot. And this is to show how the stones came back as well on the beach with the flood. And it's very, very big work, and look at the big trunks there. Yes, it's very big work. And indeed, this job is not made by the city, it's it's an association, you know, this little harbor, and the people, they have this machine, and whenever they need to repair their part of the beach, they do it themselves. So that's how it goes in Ventimiglia. Everybody manages its part of the beach, you know, because actually, yes, they are, I guess they are considered as privately managed, maybe. This is why they need to do it by themselves. But see the mess again, it's unbelievable. So here we have the trench he opened in the stones, and see, it's quite big because we need to have those boats actually to provide them with an access to the sea. So here, as you can see, this restaurant has dug a trench actually between him there, and there is a trench in the middle, and then the wall of wood, and then the sea. So with this system actually, he avoids the risk of flood, and but he needs to create quite a big work as well. And we clearly see that his part is clean, but on the other side it's such a mess. So now we wouldn't be able actually to do that on the whole beach. So I guess this person and this restaurant owner is trying to save actually its activity. And but yes, with the effects of climate change, in a couple of years the beach might be submerged indeed, and those walls and those systems won't really resist anymore. And see, this is quite big, huh? Because look, so yes, they used the cats, I believe, and here is the line of wood behind. So here, this little port has reopened actually a trench as well to reach the sea. So yes, they pushed all the wood and all the stones to have a safe path. And here they created actually a sort of bed for the water of the city to reach the sea. So here it is. They used a caterpillar probably to do it. It was important because there was a sort of river within celebrity in this, and because people sleep under this bridge where there is mud and water, so that's a problem.